Hi everybody, my name is Kunal. I will be your host for today. Welcome to Geek Fruit Presents Why Would I Know That? I'm going to call on your first guest. She's actually defending champion of the last show that we had. Please welcome on stage / camera, Anu Menon. Hi Anu,
Hi,
how are
Kunal.
You?
Namaste Kunalji.
Are you excited to defend your honor?
Defend my honor? Is that what it's come to? Like I'm bloody
Draupadi
now. I'm wearing the wrong clothes.
Yeah. That's perfect. I'm going to call on your second guest for today, who also happens to be a defending champion from a previous edition of Why Would I Know That. Let's welcome on stage Ronak Rajani.
Hey, thank you. Hey.
How are you doing, man? You feeling good?
I'm good, my man. How you been, bro?
Good. I'm good, man. I'm good. We're very excited that your internet is working finally. And the third participant today is a very dear friend of mine, as every stand-up comic ever says. Please welcome with an applause, Saurabh Pant.
Hey, hey.
Let's get up. It's me. I'm a Bangladeshi. Bangladesh locks Dhaka for championship.
Yeah, come on.
Saurabh, we're not covering cricket.
My commitment to this bit could be that if I do this entire bit in this Tiger mask.
That won't help you still, Saurabh.
Hey, listen, we're least... defending champions. I have nothing to lose. This is like AIC all over again.
At least this frame is prettier. Our first round is called Connect Me. It's a very simple thing. The order is Anu first, then Ronak, then Saurabh. Saurabh, loving the hat. Well done. Question one to Anu Menon. You get 20 points if you get it right. And if you don't get it, it passes on to the next and passes on to the last for half the points. Anu, find the connection between these four people.
They're all singers.
I want something more specific.
They are...
First of all, who are they?
Second, they're British. Justin Timberlake. This one that Take Me, Robbie Williams, Take Me, I'm saying Take That. A third one, I don't know. I'm just assuming he's a singer. This is that boy, yeah. That cute one. That one.
Yeah.
That singer boy. They've all acted as well. They're singers who've also acted.
That is not true for Simon Webb, but I'm gonna...
Fine, at least I know his name now. Simon Webb.
I'm gonna pass on to Ronak. Ronak, any guesses?
They have not all acted.
In those to Saurabh and then I'm sorry, you lost your chance.
So I have the joke answer and then I have the actual answer. Both of them blew me. All four. Sorry, I fucked up. The correct answer is that they all four had successful solo careers after leaving the band. And I don't know who the middle guy is.
Fuck. That's
you
true.
Know, that's that.
You were the last person I expected to get that answer right, but well done. You get 10 points for that. They were all ex-boy band singers.
So close.
Who is that?
You know why Saurabh knows the answer? Because Saurabh is also ex-boy band member. That's right.
All right, second question. Same thing. Connect me now to Mr. Ronak Rajani. Find the connection. Between these four things. Remember, this is a pop culture quiz.
All right. They all have Bollywood songs. What up? What up? What up?
Yes.
What
I'll
up?
Give it to you. Although, technically, Lamborghini is not a Bollywood song, but I'll still give it to you. 20 points. Well played. Okay, cool. We're going to move on to our final question in this round.
Pussy, honey, kissy, plenty.
Remember again, pop culture. So yeah, it should give you a clue.
Sorry, I got a missed call. Things that Saurabh never gets. Life insurance.
That's not the answer, Saurabh.
I'm gonna say
things that Eva holds back on.
It's funny because it's true. this sounds
have you,
like.
Have you tried? Have you tried dressing up as a tiger?
Dude, that's why she keeps saying no. She's from the PETA. She's like, I cannot harm animals. These are names of Bond, something Bond girls or some shit.
What is that? Is that what you're going with? Is that your answer?
I think so.
That actually is correct, Saurabh. What a wild
wow!
Actually, is you weren't sure at all, right?
I mean, you know what? This is the weird part. I thought it was Austin Powers. And then I'm like, no, that doesn't make sense because there's nobody called like Plenty or whatever the shit.
Yeah. Do any guesses on the on their full names?
Pussy Galore.
Correct.
Honey Singh. Honey Boo Boo.
No, it's not.
Kissy Kissy Bang Bang.
It's
and Dinah Plenty.
All right. So, round two.
Wait 1 second. Ronak has a nice cap, man. Let's acknowledge the fact that he's made an effort.
That's right.
What is the cap?
That's right, Heisenberg. It's just me and you who made an effort.
Yeah, but then he also has his t-shirt, so that's kind of offsetting.
Ronak, did you buy this or did someone give it to you as a gift, this cap?
My friend was in US when the big Trump rallies were going on, and I was like, please, can you buy it for me?
The round two, the devil's in the detail. This is a potentially very high scoring round. There is a long list of answers and we want you to be able to give us as many answers as you can get, potentially 5 answers. Your first question is for Anu Menon. Here it is. The Mark Twain Prize for American Humor has been presented since 1998. Name any 5 winners from 2010 to 2019. So the last 10 years, basically.
Tina Fey, Dave Chappelle.
And then I will tell you whether they're right, okay? Tina Fey, Dave Chappelle.
Eddie Murphy, Jerry Seinfeld. I don't know. I don't know the years and all now. Amy Poehler.
You've given me 5 answers, of which 3 are right. Tina Fey, Eddie Murphy, and Dave Chappelle are correct.
Will Ferrell?
Okay, fine. I'm going to give it to you.
I was going to say Will Ferrell. I was next. Okay.
No answers from Anu. 4 answers right. Ronak, you get one more opportunity to... Like, you can try 5 names, but try and get one right.
Manoj Bajpayee.
Not correct. I can tell you up front.
Hey, I know. Can I answer again?
Robin Williams.
Passing on.
Judd Apatow. Sapan Verma. And Mark Twain himself.
All 5 answers are wrong.
This what?
Score up.
Sapan Verma did not even win the East India Comedy Award for top 7 comedians.
Oh, shit.
Saurabh, your turn.
Bill Murray. I have to guess
that is
5
correct.
New
you
people,
get
right?
The 1 point that you're allowed to get.
Okay, and I'll tell you one more thing about Bill Murray. That if you saw the video, Bill Murray did a fucking awesome thing where he took the award and he gave it to the audience and it went fucking everywhere. There's also David Letterman, there's also Jay Leno, there's also Johnny Lever.
Okay, was Julia Louis-Dreyfus one of them?
Yes, the answer
was,
on the screen.
Was
right
Jay
now.
Leno one of them? Was Jay Leno one of them?
Yes. Yeah. Okay, come on. Well done, guys. Well done. This is a very high scoring, potentially high scoring round. Anu, I think you got 40 points and Saurabh gets 5 for getting a passed on half point. Well done. Second question in Devil's in the Detail is going to be to Mr. Ronak Rajani. Ronak.
All Bollywood songs.
Actually, we're not doing a Bollywood one, but
shit!
Over the 10 seasons of Friends, several guest stars appeared as boyfriends of Monica, Phoebe, and Rachel. Name any 5 actors.
Brad Pitt.
I'm looking for boyfriends of Monica and Phoebe. I wanted to give me 5 names and I will tell you at the end of it whether it's right or wrong. Guy, have any more actor names?
Dated all of them together?
No, any of them.
Okay. Sorry.
How is buying time?
Bruce Willis.
Minus point.
Bruce Willis, Brad Pitt. Who's our guy in Home Alone? No.
Macaulay Culkin.
Okay.
Also,
give
Ross.
Give me 2 more.
They were on a break, Ronak. It doesn't count.
That's true.
Give me 1 more name. Just go for it.
1 more name. Okay. Keanu Reeves.
Wrong. Okay, you got 1 right. No. Bruce Willis is correct.
Brad Pitt. I said Brad Pitt first.
Brad Pitt did not date any of them. So that's wrong.
Kevin James.
And also Macaulay Culkin and whoever the last person was. Rubbish. Just shut up. This question now moves on to Saurabh. Anu, wait, I know you're excited. Saurabh, give me 5 minutes.
I hate America.
Tom Selleck, Paul Rudd.
Damage.
I don't know the rest, man. Whatever. That's all I know. I know.
All right. So you did get two rights. You get two half.
I don't know.
But three so far: Paul Rudd, Bruce Willis, and Tom Selleck. Anu, any more guesses?
Shocking. The only two I knew, the stupid bloody Baldy knew also. I don't know. Fun Bob. I have no idea. I have no idea now.
Fun Bob was not really a guest. I was just.
I know, dude. I don't know.
I want to give you the answers, guys. Here it is: Alec Baldwin.
No, that's not Isaac. Sorry, I got excited.
Is it Alec Baldwin by chance? Was it Alec Baldwin?
Nice. Yeah. John Favreau, guys. How did you guys forget John Favreau?
Oh, shit. Yeah, because he made such a shit Lion King. I've not forgiven him. That's why.
Yeah, but he made...
I was so busy building my own career. And I was like, John Favreau, fucking... My best friend, John Favreau, who comes frequently to Cuckoo Club to do open mic nights with us.
Yeah.
Question in Devil's in the Detail. This time to Mr. Panty. Shah Rukh Khan plays a character named Rahul in 8 films. Name any 5 films. Give me 5 names.
Ting 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 ting. That's 8. Dikwale Dulhania Le Jayenge. And then there was that fucking Mehuna. Om Shanti Om. I'm going to say Badshah.
Give me 2 more names. Okay, Badshah and...
That fuck all Tatti movie. What the fuck is it name? Was he in Tal?
No, that wasn't it.
Oh, that Laudu movie. The fun with fucking Zaid Khan being a chud.
You just said Mehuna.
I said Mehuna.
Yeah. Was that a sequel?
Yeah, and also Shah Rukh Khan featured as one of the boyfriends of Phoebe in Friends. And he played Rahul, so it was unbuilt.
Very nice. 0 points. Like all the names, all the movies you named, he played Raj. Okay, so
shit.
0 points. This goes on to Anu Menon. You still have the opportunity to win a full 50.
Kuch kuch hota hai. कुछ कुछ होता है मोहब्बतें प्रेम ए लिसन व्हाट इज दैट मूवी यार दैट प्रेम समथिंग विद दिव्या भारती एंड ऋषि कपूर वाजंट इन दैट प्रेम समथिंग ओके नेवर माइंड ए जो शट अप
प्रेम रतन धन पायो
सी नो प्रेम ग्रंथ प्रेम समथिंग ओके लीव इट
प्रेम ग्रंथ या इज दैट
वाज ही राहुल इन डर इन अजनबी इन बाजीगर
Can you just give me names? Just tell me the 5 names. You said
so many. I'm giving you. Hai,
Dar, then.
Ajnabi, Dar, Bazigar, Mohabbatein, Kuch Kuch Hota Hai.
Ho gaya. Bas. So you got 2 right, which is Dar and Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. The others, he's not named Rahul. So this finally goes to my good friend Ronak Rajani.
You. Acha, abhi to good friend ban gaya.
Potentially, getting 3 answers right. Come on, go for it, Rahul.
K3G. K3G, Dil to Pagal Hai, Iqbal, and Chennai Express.
You got three right, Ronak. Well done. K3G,
come on, India,
and DDPH.
That's right. No longer America. We are India. That's right.
Final answers: Dar, Zamana Diwana, Yes Boss, DDPH, KKHH, HDJPK, K3G, and CE. I really expected Saurabh to get this right, but I guess I was way off.
Dude, I don't notice characters' names. I just notice their motivations because I go beyond superficial things like names. I look at motivations and the psychological impact we'll have on the show.
Right.
Thank you so much.
That's why I'm watching this show.
I'm Anu Menon. I appreciate it.
Yeah, so she has a dead peacock in her house.
It's a fan, dude. It's a fan. I've been trying to, you know, like, I'm trying to get this aura and this halo and all going. Yeah, I don't know.
Anu, just centralize yourself or just, I feel like hitting tab on your screen right now. A couple of times you come to the center. I'm just going to move.
Is that better for you, Kunal? Yeah? That's, yeah?
Yes, much better. Thank you. It's my OCD who's kicking in.
This is my resting bitch face.
As long as off screen, you're nice to me, we're okay.
Will you give me 20 points if I get the cap twirl and land on my head? Okay, here goes.
You know what? I will give you 10 points.
Oh, really? Okay, that would be tough.
You get 2 chances. That's your first. Okay. Now you get 1 more chance.
Oh my god, I did it. I'm amazing.
Excellent. Good problem.
No. Will you give me, will you give me 20 points? Will you give me 20 points if I remove tissue paper from my mouth?
I just balanced a glass on my head. Come on. Come on. It's very ladylike.
What up? 20 points.
Peetal. Peetal.
Okay, I'll give 20 points to anyone who can catch my cap on the head. Okay, I'm going to throw it towards you guys.
Whoa!
Oh, Ronald did it! 20 points.
Okay, we're going to quickly move on to our round three, which is our self-titled round called Why Would I Know That? Again, a very high-scoring round. You get three clues. You get the first clue. If you get the answer right on the first clue, you get 60 points. On the second clue, you'll get 40 points and 20 points if you get it on the third clue. And the question only passes to the next participant after all three clues are given out. So, the first question. The latest installment of this classic movie franchise is the highest grossing film of 2020 so far. Name the film or the franchise.
Of 2020?
Yes, 2020 so far.
Okay, then I have no idea. Okay, next.
Clue two. The plot of Amitabh Bachchan / Govinda starrer Bade Mia Chote Mia was lifted from the first movie of this franchise. Are Saurabh is nodding.
Oh, this is a Bollywood movie.
No, it's a Hollywood movie, but the plot of Bade Mia Chote Mia was lifted from this film.
Next clue. Really
20 points. In 1995, Will Smith was mostly known as a sitcom star. This movie kicked off his action blockbuster career.
I can't be Muhammad Ali. After Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, like what did he do? Men in Black.
That is not the right answer.
Independence Day.
Stop. You only get one answer, otherwise you just give the clue to the next guy.
Ronak knows the answer, man.
This is gonna move on to Ronak. Do you know the answer?
Bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna work out for you?
Oh god, that's disgusting. It was so nice until you took freaking tissue paper out of your mouth, man. That is correct. Bad Boys, the franchise. They actually grossed $419 million in 2020, which is Bad Boys 3. Right. I think it's called Bad Boys.
Will Smith was Amitabh Bachchan.
Yeah.
Hey, but that was quite a googly. I didn't know this Bade Mia Chote Mia angle. Huh.
I know.
Do you guys know how there's that Salman Khan movie that they say Adam Sandler copied? Just Go With It, they say, is a copy of Maine Pyar Kyun Kiya. So everybody said that Adam Sandler copied from Salman Khan. But they both are actually copied from a 1960s Hollywood movie called Cactus Rose. So they both are actually copied.
Is this a fact that didn't make the IFA script finally? Is this what happened?
No, bro. There's some shit that this boy knows. This boy didn't only study at IFA time.
Okay, Ronak, this question is for you. Why would I know that? Potentially 60 points if you get it right on the first clue. This singer was born in Patna, Bihar and went on to become one of the most successful Indian pop artists of all time. One of his iconic dances is included as a character animation in the game World of Warcraft and as an Easter egg in Medal of Honor Allied Assault.
Is it Dalal Mehndi?
It freaking is! You are a genius!
That's right!
How did you get that right? I did not know this. Well played! The full 60 points. This has never happened in the history of 2.5 shows of Why Would I Know That? There you go. Dalal Mehndi is the answer. Well played. Final question of Why Would I Know That for Mr. Saurabh Pant. This TV show initially had the working title Chasing Zebras and Circling the Drain, which were both references to common medical slang. The eventual title was also a nod to a medical slang term.
Scrubs.
Not correct. I will ask. I will give you the second clue, but I like the way you're thinking. The second clue, named for its lead character, this show propelled its star to new heights of fame. In 2008, it was the most watched TV show in the world, and Guinness World Records listed him as the most watched man on television. What? ER. Yes, named for his lead character.
Yeah. Oh, wait. Sanjeevni, a medical bull.
For Karan Singh Grover.
Neither of those are right. I will give you the final clue, my friend. The show's lead character.
Fuck this guy. I don't know. Fuck this bastard.
Who? What? Wait, what?
It's House, man, bastard.
It is House. Why are you so upset with me or the question?
Because I was like, fucking this. I should have known this. Because okay. I'm a fan of the lead actor, Altaf Raja. He's one of my favorite comedians.
I know.
Will you give me extra points for my guess? His name is Hugh Lowdy.
I will give you extra
points. Huge Lowdy. Sorry, I fucked it up. Huge Lowdy.
I will give you extra points if you know what the medical slang hidden in the name of the show is.
Houseman's disease.
No, but good random guess. HOU, which is history of use, which is a term used for drug addicts. HOU or HO, history of use, house put together.
Yeah.
It's just a subtle nod, as they say. Okay, guys. All right. We're going to move to the final round, which is themed lightning, which is our rapid fire round. You get to pick a category. There are 10 questions that you have to complete in 90 seconds. Saurabh, you get to choose your questions from any of these categories. Number one, the life of Chunky Pandey, to British sitcoms and Indian indie pop from the 90s. Choose which category you want questions in.
You know what? I know surprisingly a lot about Chunky Pandey's life. And I know a lot about British sitcoms. Uh-huh. So I'm going to go with Indian indie pop from the 90s.
Oh dear God, Saurabh. This is why we started from the bottom of the list as far as points go. So you get the opportunity to do a high scoring final round. But fine.
Where's the fun in that? What's the point of this? Unless it's like there's a fucking conflict and it's some bullshit happening. Come on. I accept. I'm going to come from behind and win this thing and become like Bob Willis. Lucky Ali. I'm going to become like Lucky Ali.
You go, girl. I will read out 10 questions on indie pop from the 90s. You have 90 seconds to answer them. Number one, name the famous male model and now famous marathon runner that appears in...
Milind Soman!
Correct. Name this indie pop legend who has in recent years made a resurgence with internet hits like Chicken Fried Rice, Swachh Bharat, and Going. That is correct. Number three, Lisa Ray was the model in the music video of which
Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan
song? Which song?
Afri.
Correct. Lucky Ali's first single, Oh Sanam, was nominated at the 1997 MTV Video Music Awards. Name the album. You can't say pass.
Osanam.
No, it's not. It's Suno. Question five.
Which
prolific London-based Indian music producer was behind albums like Made in India, Johnny Joker and Naujawan?
Biddu
is correct. Biwa and Asma were pop band winners of the Indian version of which international talent show?
Channel V's... Fuck me in the dick. That's the name of the show.
Second part.
So Anumanan is very excited.
Do you pass? It's V Pop Stars. Number seven. Which former model and later Bollywood star appeared in the 1998 Sonu Nigam pop song Two? Two.
It was Randalina Khan.
No, it was Bipasha Basu. Question eight. I've started, so I'll finish. Sunita Rao was born in Germany, but did her higher studies in which Mumbai college?
St. Xavier's?
That is correct. Well done, Saurabh. You got a shitload of answers right. I'm very
impressed. I'm just offended that there was no question about Shweta Shetty and Johnny Joker.
Listen, we only have 10 questions.
I just feel like, come on. Just horrible. And very easy questions also you asked him.
There was a question we asked about Biddu produced Johnny Joker. We asked that question.
Fine.
Ball.
Guys, what the fuck is Johnny's Joker?
Johnny Joker. Divana, Mastana. Okay,
Boomer.
I'm not yet a boomer. Not yet, yeah. I'm saying. I don't come in that category. Huh, come on, say.
But Ronak is still the closest to... Who is the only one who's eligible to say that to us. So cool. Saurabh, I think you did a lot of points and you potentially might be... I don't know whether you're leading.
Very good.
So, now Anu Menon...
Very good.
From the remaining two
categories. Now, British sitcoms. Obviously, I have nothing. Huh.
You have nothing. Okay, fine. British
nothing. I have nothing.
It is. I will ask you 10 questions. You have 90 seconds. And obviously, this doesn't pass. One. Stephen Fry and Hugh Laurie act in sitcom Jeeves and Wooster based on which British author's story?
P.G. Woodhouse.
Correct. In the show, Kumar's at number 42. Who plays Kumar's grandmother?
Sanjeev. Oh, Meera Sayal.
Correct. Jim Hacker, Bernard Woolley, and Sir Humphrey Appleby are the main characters of which award-winning political satire of the 80s?
Yes, Prime Minister.
I'll give it to you. Yes, Minister or Yes, Prime Minister. In the sitcom IT Crowd, how does the head and owner of Renam Industries die in season 1?
I don't know because I don't watch it. Huh.
Okay, he kills himself by jumping out the window. Question 5.
He kills himself by jumping out the window. Yeah.
In the 1977 highly racist sitcom Mind Your Language, what was the name of the professor?
Okay,
you can come back to it.
Let me think. Okay.
Okay, in the 1992...
Mr. White!
That's wrong, it's Mr. Brown.
I said Mr. Brown after Mr. White.
You're running out of time. The 1992 British comedy show Alo Alo is centered around a cafe called Cafe René. Where is it located?
Gone off. Huh. What is the question you went off? Centered around a cafe?
Cafe René was... Where is it located?
Time is up.
In Paris.
I'll give it to you. It's France. We got cut, so I'm going to ask you one more question. In season 5 of British sitcom Coupling, the popular character of Jeff was replaced by which character?
I have no idea. Stephen. Martin. No,
it's Oliver. Jim. Well done. You did well. These were slightly tough questions and you wasted a lot of time on Mr. Brown, but still, well played. Respectable. I'm very impressed. So we're going to go with Ronak Rajani doing the life of Chunky Pandey. What is Chunky's character in the Houseful series called?
Chunkya.
Wrong. It's Akhri Pasta. Question 2.
Akhri Pasta.
In which film did Chunky's daughter Ananya make her debut?
Student of the Year. 2.
Correct. In the film Tezab, what song is sung by Chunky Pandey's character Babban while driving a van? It was also remixed in 2019's Bypass Road.
Tu hi tu satrangi re.
That is incorrect. It is So Gaya Ye Jaha.
So Gaya Ye Jaha.
That is right. You only have 90 seconds. Calm down. How many Houseful movies have been released so far? Released.
4.
Correct. There's a 5th one in production. In Aankhe, Govinda asks Ritu Shivpuri, Oh Lal Dupatte Wali Tera Naam To Bata. What does Chunky ask Rageshwari?
Tera Kaam To Bata. He says, Pata To Bata.
No, it's, Oh Kale Kurte Wali Tera Naam To Bata. Question 6. Chunky has been paired with this actress the most number of times, including 5 hit films. Name her.
Hema Malini.
No, Neelam. Chunky made his streaming debut with this alt Balaji series. Name it.
name the show. The show is Pyar Dhoka Love.
No, it's Baby Come Now.
Stop.
Yeah.
Well, Bengal Tiger.
I got to give Ronak Rajani saying Chunkya at the top.
It set the tone.
Okay, by the way, I have to ask this question. Does anybody know Chunky Pandey's real name?
Yeah.
Bangladesh ka Shahrukh.
Bangladesh ka Shahrukh.
Funky Pandey.
Ravi.
No, none of you guys
know. Bishnoi.
Ashutosh. Kunal
Rakewala.
Kunal Rao.
Kunal Rao.
Kunal Kamra. Kunal Kamra Pandey.
What is it?
Ananya.
Suyash Pandey.
Ananya Kabab.
Suyash. I'm sorry, I lost you for a minute. Is it Suyash?
Alright, thank you guys for participating. It's a very close contest. Thank you, everybody.
Really, I knew I had a bad feeling coming in that I was going to lose today. I just knew it. I just knew it. But I didn't think I would lose to Saurabh.
More wicked shows happening. And we'd love to have you all back.
My friends call me. They call me Chunkya the Encyclopedia. That's right.
They will call you Suyash from now on. Well played, Ronnie. Well played, Saurabh Pan. Thank you, Anu Menon. Thank you, Geek
Fruit. Bye-bye.
And Insider. Thanks to all our audience members for coming in. And have a good night.